Hello friends, this is Dev from Bangalore Revenants Cricket Club, and today I am here to share with you a few of the things related to cricket. So today my topic is, what are the items that is a must for your cricket bat kit? So bat, pad, gloves, these are essentials, I believe everyone knows. But apart from that, there are a few of the items that are very, very essential that must be there within your kit. So I would like to share with you a few of the items. So first item that I would like to share is the mallet. So it is a wooden mallet. It can be purchased from any sports shop for around 350, 400 or even 500 rupees max. So you can have this wooden mallet for the knocking of cricket bat. So anyways, whenever you buy a cricket bat, either you give it for knocking to any shop for machine knocking, but hand knocking is must for every cricket bat. Even if you knock the cricket bat with the machine, still you need the edges to be curved, and without this mallet it cannot be done. So next is few of the old balls. If you can collect whichever club you are playing, so you can collect one or two balls from the when the matches are over, and you can have it. Because when you are buying a new bat, then while knocking you cannot use the new ball, so better you can use it old ball so that the mark doesn't impress on the bat face. So the next is the bat tape. So this is a GM bat tape which I bought it from the sports shop. It is costing around 200 rupees. It will be around 10 meter, and it can last for, you can use it many number of times, 5 to 10 times you can use it, depending on the usage or depending on how much you change your tape. So this tape is basically to save your edges of the bat. So whenever you are buying a new bat, after the knocking, you should use this tape on the side, on the edges of the bat, so that the whenever the ball hits it, the wood doesn't come out. So this is another important item, you should keep it. Next is the linseed oil. So this one is a GLS linseed oil, but I would recommend you to buy for any SS or SG raw linseed oil. So what basically raw linseed oil is, it is a kind of oil which is used to hold the moisture of the bat. So whenever a new bat is bought, it needs to be oiled. You can oil it after 6 months also, but still if you can oil it on the initial days, it will lock up the moisture within the bat and it will not make your bat brittle. In market there are two types of oils available, linseed oils, which most of the people don't know. I think there are two types of linseed oil. One is the raw linseed oil, another is the cooked linseed oil. So never buy a cooked linseed oil, because if you buy that oil and apply it in your bat face, what will happen? It will soak all the moisture. In that case, your bat will break just within 2 to 3 times of session, 2 to 3 sessions in the matches. So better not to buy that cooked oil and cooked linseed oil, and go for the raw linseed oil, which will keep the moisture bind inside the wood and help your bat to perform better and last longer. The next important thing that is required is this tape. It is called the adhesive tape, which you can get it in any medical shop. So what basically it is, whenever you get cut or something during the matches or during your next session, you can apply it in your wound or something so that the blood doesn't come out immediately. Then the next important thing, another thing which is important to have in the kit bag, is the this adhesive. So there are many types of adhesives available in the market, but I am talking about this Fevi Bond, which is available at around 20 or 25 rupees. So what it is used for is, because whenever you buy a new cricket bat, you may not have the toe guard in the bat. I will show you what is toe guard basically. So this black part is called the toe guard. It's a rubber or polymer, some type of polymer made rubber piece, which is fixed with the cricket bat in the toe, so that whenever you drag your bat while running or while you are batting, hitting the pitch, so your bat will not get damaged in the from the bottom part, and this will protect you from getting the bat toe damaged. So what the function of this Fevi bond is, while sticking this toe guard, you need this Fevi bond. So I have tried with other adhesives like Fevi Call or Fevi Quick, or even I used some other Fevi Stick, something like that, but those are not that good as compared with the Fevi bond, because it is only made for this type of purposes, like fixing a rubber with the wood or something like that. The next important thing, which generally people don't, even the cricket players don't do that or keep it in their kit, is this sandpaper. Now you must be thinking that we are not preparing bats, so let me clear you all that this sandpaper is for cleaning the surface. Whenever you are buying a new bat, it has some wax polish or something like that. So whenever you are putting oil on that bat, on that new bat, the oil will not be soaked or the oil will not go inside the bat. So in that case, what you have to do basically is you have to take a sandpaper of 20 or 25 microns. Don't take the sandpapers of smaller microns, because it will it may damage the bearing. So go for thicker dots, so that it doesn't damage the bearing. And anyways, you are not putting lot of effort in rubbing that bat. Just you have to take the bat and make a little roughness on the surface, on the sides, both sides, and on the bottom if the toe guard is not there. And if toe guard is there, no need to do that. Just rub it slightly so that you can see that the wax has been removed and some roughness comes, so that whenever you put the oil in the bat for oiling, it will soak inside very well, and it will make the bat perform, it will improve the bat performance. So as of now, I have all these things available, so we will come up with new videos. Till then,